Hey guys, so as you can tell, my hair is wet and sorry about that, but today's video I'm going to be testing out some new drugstore makeup. Well, not really new in the stores, but just new to me. So as you can tell right back here, I have my makeup, and on this side, you know, all the drugstore makeup and stuff. So yeah, I'm so excited about this video. It is way long overdue. Yeah, it is currently like a sauna in my room right now. I'm like sweating and I'm wearing the sweater. So that's that. And I know my last video, my hair was also wet, but that was because it was like a get ready with me, and my hair is just wet right now because I took a shower, obviously. And yeah, that's pretty much it. If you are new here, please make sure to hit the subscribe and like button. And let's just get on to the video.
We're here.
Honking. I'm leaving this amazing place right behind me, and now I'm gonna go home, and then I'm gonna film my makeup tomorrow because, as you can tell, it's really dark out. I'm too late, so now we're gonna go home, and I'll see you tomorrow. Now I moved over to my desk slash vanity, and I have all my makeup laid out right here. I'm going to be looking right here and sometimes right here just to make sure it's still recording and to make sure that I'm still in the frame and stuff. So my mirror's right here again. I'm gonna look here, and yeah, so we're just gonna start this. I've never done anything like this, so I'm a little nervous, but you know what, makeup is makeup. Like, you can always, makeup always looks good on everybody the way you do it and stuff. So we're gonna start off by putting my ears. You probably can't see it, but that's just to get it out of my face. So the first thing I'm gonna try out is the Maybelline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser, and this is like the dupe to the Benefit Porefessional, as you can tell, and I'm pretty sure it does the same thing. So we're gonna just try this on my skin. I'm gonna put a little bit. Ooh, she's thick. That's what it looks like. Kind of looks like jelly. You see that? So just gonna try this. Ooh, not sure how I feel about this consistency, but we're gonna try staying positive, okay? Going to put this mostly in the center of my face because that's where I get like the most pores. And then I'm also going to use another primer on the perimeter of my face. So yeah, just like that. I'll just bring it down my neck because I have excess. I can't speak today. So I have tried this before, but I've only used it like one time, and I forgot to mention some of these products I've used before. That's because I either couldn't find another like product like it or just something like that. So I'm going to use the NYX Honey Do Me Up primer, and it looks like really thick, like honey and stuff, but when you put it on your face, it like melts. It's so cool, and there's like little gold flakes in it. So this I'm going to put on the outside and maybe just a little under my eyes for the primer, or the concealer, sorry. So now I'm just going to blend this. And also, this I really like a glowy look more than like a matte kind of finish. So I'm going to put this on the outside just to, you know, make it more moisturized and glowy. And yeah, now we're just, you know, we're gonna move on to the... Okay guys, so for the foundation, I don't have a drugstore foundation, so I had to go pick this up. And also, I've just wanted this for a really long time because I heard really good things about it. So the foundation I'm gonna be using is the Wet n Wild Photo Focused Foundation in Soft Beige. This is what it looks like. I was testing this inside of Target, not testing, but I was kind of like seeing if it's like my shade and stuff. And I really think that this might match. Might be a little dark because it is winter and I have like no tan, so just gonna try this. And then the beauty blender I have is this one. I don't remember where it was from, but it's like just like a beauty blender. It's like super squishy. So I'm going to take this. Oh, it has an applicator like the NYX primer. So I'm just gonna put this kind of just like all over my face. First thought is that it's very soft, of course it is. And I might need another layer of this, but you know what, we're gonna see. That should be good. And now I'm just gonna blend it before it dries, just in case if this foundation dries like really fast. So yeah, I'm just gonna blend this. Wow, it kind of looks like it matches perfectly. I'm gonna see this. So yeah, in Target, there were so many people, so that's why I forgot to kind of record a lot. Not a lot, but like more than I would have, because I really wanted to, but there were just so many people, and every time I tried to whip out my camera, they were like looking at me, and then someone was like, oh, do you need help, you know, that worked there, and I was like, oh, no, thank you, and then, yeah, I just didn't record, but I hope you guys are okay with that. This right side looks like I put more than the left side, which is weird. I don't think I did, but I'll look at the footage over and see. And then I don't have a eyeshadow primer, so I'm gonna kind of put the excess on my lids, and then I'm gonna use the concealer that I got also. So yeah. I really like this foundation. We're gonna kind of have to see how this holds up through the day. This like looks pretty damn good. So yeah, foundation is done. I really like to blend a lot because I just don't like to have like any streakies on my face. But yeah, so the concealer that I got is the e.l.f. HD Lifting Concealer in Fair, and this is what it looks like. I have a few drugstore concealers, but I really wanted to just kind of try out a new foundation. If I could get it out of this box, that would be really lovely. Okay, so this is what it looks like. It's definitely smaller than I thought. I thought it was going to be, you know, in like a bigger tube like this or something. But I mean, oh yeah, I forgot to say the price. Okay, I'm so sorry. The foundation was $5.99, which is a really good price for concealer because my other ones are like $50. I'm just like, why would I ever pay $50 for a foundation? I really don't know, but I did, so yeah. But this is the concealer and it's $3, and I really hope it is my shade for how I like my under eyes to be. I really don't like them to be too light, and this is the lightest one, and this is in Fair, like I said. So yeah, we're just gonna see. Okay, first impression, super creamy. Like, this is like so creamy. Like, oh my god. So I'm just gonna put this in the highlights of my face. So now we have that. I think I'm just gonna use the same beauty blender and just blend this. I love the way that blends into my skin. Oh, yes. It's definitely... Okay, just poked my eye. It's great. Okay, but what I was gonna say is that it's definitely not as full coverage as my everyday foundation, which I'm sorry, that really hurt my eye. Okay. But my everyday foundation is this one. It is the Too Faced Born This Way. And so that one is like super, super full coverage. But this one, I feel like it just does the job. I don't know. I guess it just conceals your face. But I'm really liking it. Just gonna put it on my eyelids. And as I said, I love to blend. So that's why it's probably gonna be like 5 minutes of me literally just blending everything together. Okay. So now that the concealer and foundation are done, I'm just gonna go into powder. So I always use the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. So I just got a new one. I kind of used it last night, so it's not really my first impressions, but I use this like all the freaking time. So that's why it looks kind of used, and this powder is just my favorite. So I'm just gonna put a little under my eyes and then my nose, forehead, and chin. And then take a little bit more and just swirl this. My skin feels like so soft. I really hope this is my shade. Like, I really can't tell. So you guys are gonna have to tell me down below if this is my shade or not. I'm gonna put a little on my eyelids for when I do my eyeshadow. So yes. Now that the powder is done, let's move on to. Okay, so next I'm going to use the, what is this? The e.l.f. blush in Blushing. I really could not find any blush like from any brand there, and my only blushes I have I have like two, like one from Tarte and one from Benefit. So I thought I would just give this one a try. I'm going to swatch this to see how pigmented it is. Okay, definitely not that pigmented, but you know what? Don't judge a book by its cover. So I definitely just flicked that. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm gonna take this blush. I think I'm gonna have to put a lot in here and just. It's super natural. Okay, you know what? I like this. It just gives like a natural kind of glow to your skin. And also some color to your face. Do we like? Do we like? Just going to blend. Okay, I'm honestly really happy with this blush. $2 at Target. I'm sure CVS has it. Okay, so for my eyebrows, I actually couldn't find just an individual like spoolies anywhere. So I just looked inside of my makeup and I found this. So I'm just gonna use this for my eyebrows. I don't really like to do, as you guys know, too much to my eyebrows. So I'm just going to comb them out like this and then fill in the sparse areas with this Pixie Shape of Brows powder palette. And I'm gonna use a mixture of the third and fourth one right here. I've used this before and I was being rushed by my mom last night to just pick one out. I was like, I don't know which one, and she's like, just pick it out. And then I was like, you know what? I think I'll just use it at home, like one that I have. So as you can see, just kind of filling in these sparse areas. And now I'm going to do my other brow. This one I don't have to do like as much to it. I don't know why. They're not twins, they're sisters, but yeah. So I'm just gonna do that, and then this one needs a little bit more. So yeah, that's all I do with that. And then I'm gonna take the spoolie again and just kind of blend. And then the brows are done. That's literally all I do. So yes. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to contour, but I just realized, so I wanted to try this contour out, but I put powder over my foundation, and I normally like to put a contour under, especially if it's cream, and this is cream, but you know what, we're just gonna try this. So I'm using the Wet n Wild contour stick, it looks just like this, and then I'm just gonna do a little bit. And then just a little under here, and then just do a little bit up here, so just the tiniest bit. And then I'm gonna take the Expert Face Brush from Real Techniques. This is my favorite brush ever. Like, I use this all the time and I just love it so much. I'm just gonna kind of blend this. Oh, I really don't like this. I don't like this contour thing. I feel like it looks like kind of muddy. I'm just going to blend. I like the way this looks on my forehead though. Like the contour, and I'm just gonna blend this up into my hairline. Yeah, so because I kind of messed this up, I'm gonna take these off and then just, you know, re-put this back on if I can. Okay, so now that the contour is done, at the end I'll kind of fix it up, but I'm just going to move on to the eyeshadow. So I found this jumbo eye pencil, and it is a, I guess it's like an, it's like an eyeshadow. So I'm gonna just put this on the eyelids, and this is in the shade Yogurt. Looks like this. And what got me drawn to this was the color. Do you see that? It's like a rose gold kind of color, and it just, it's so pretty. So I really wanted to try this out, and I thought it'd be a good video to do that. So I'm just going to put this all over my eyelid, and then that's literally all I'm gonna do. And then I'm just gonna blend it. I'm gonna blend it first, and then I'm going to take this NYX, what is this, Matte Finish Long Lasting Setting Spray. Sorry. And I'm just going to spray the side of this brush, and then I'm going to blend like that. So, I definitely can tell it doesn't blend that well. I guess it's just the way I'm doing this, but hey, now we know. Okay, now, oh my gosh, I'm sorry, I just had to grab that thing. But now we're just gonna take this and now we're gonna blend this side of my face or my eye. It's always like, not habit, but it's just so natural when you're like doing your eyes to like open your mouth and like, and also with mascara you're like so So I'm looking kind of weird doing this. But yeah. I really like the eyes. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna, when I run out of this thing, I'm gonna purchase this. So it is the, again, NYX Eye Pencil in Yogurt. Highly, highly, highly recommend that. So I'm just gonna put some chapstick on. And this is just CarMax. It's been so cold and windy where I live. So Now, we're almost done. I'm gonna take this eyelash curler and just curl my eyelashes. Just like so. And I'm going to take the L'Oreal Voluminous Original Mascara in black. I've used this before. It's my all-time favorite drugstore mascara. I don't know what else to say about it. It's just amazing. So I'm going to just coat my lashes. And then I know a lot of beauty gurus, when they're like, oh, okay, I'm just gonna like coat my lashes, and then they're done coating their lashes and they're like, oh, I'm gonna put some eyelash extensions on them. Just like, I don't wear fake eyelashes. See, I'm just going do this, and then after this I'm going to apply something onto my lips. So now that is done, and I'm going to use my favorite lipstick, and this is the e.l.f. What is this? The e.l.f. matte lipstick in Tea Rose. And it's just like a purple, dark color. I'm gonna take this. I love this. Like, I don't... Oh, it's so good! It's not super dark, but you can definitely tell. So this is what the lips look like. And then the final step, I'm gonna take these off. I'm gonna shake my hair out. And now I'm going to take the NYX Matte Finish spray, because I could not find a spray that kind of gave me a glowy kind of look. So I'm gonna take this and just that, just to make sure my makeup stays all day. So yeah, this is what my makeup looks like. I think it actually turned out pretty good. You don't need to have a lot of money to create a really pretty flawless look. Like this, I used, what, like $20 worth, and it gave me this really pretty date night look, which I don't have, but yeah. So I'm going to go into more daylight, not daylight, but like more light, so you guys can see the look. So yeah, if you noticed, I actually did not wear highlighter. That's because I feel like it kind of gives a little glowy look with the blush, because it has sparkles in it. So yeah. I'm going to include some pictures at the end of this video of this look. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time with a new video.